Santham Academy. Welcome to Digital Kaksha. To get updates on new videos, click the subscribe button and the bell icon.
Good morning, students. Welcome back to our e-learning class. We are studying political science of our 12th class. We have studied up till now 4 chapters. Now we have moved ahead to the 5th chapter, that is contemporary South Asia. Here we are supposed to study about the neighboring countries of India, especially the South Asian countries. So the first question arises is that what all areas, what all regions are included in this South Asian region. So basically there are 5 countries which are the members of, you can say, South Asian countries, or which we particularly refer to as South Asian countries. They are Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. These countries especially we call them the South Asian countries. These are our neighboring countries and they all fall into the South Asian region of Asia. For India, the mighty Himalayas in the north, the Arabian Sea in the south, the Indian Ocean also in the south, all these provide a natural insulator for India. That means they separate us from the threat of other regions of the area. That way our country is protected by these things. That is, from the north, the Himalayas is the long and thick and tall wall which protects us from the rest of the world from the north region. Then in the south we have oceans to the two sides in the peninsular India, and that way it provides protection to the peninsular part of India. When we talk about South Asia, we refer mainly to these 7 countries, that is Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. But Afghanistan and Myanmar also many a times included in the discussion about South Asia, because they also lie into the South Asian region. China is also an important player in this region, but we do not include it into South Asia. We include it into the North Asia, or you can say Central Asian region. So leaving China, the rest of the neighboring countries of India are included in the South Asian region. When we talk about the political history of these countries, then the various countries in South Asia, they do not have the same record of the political system. Every country has its own unique political system, slightly different and many times very radically different from the other. India have been successful in maintaining its democratic record since its independence from the British rule. Same is the case for Sri Lanka also. As soon as we got independence, we established the democratic form of government and we continue till today with the democratic form of government. Pakistan and Bangladesh, they have experienced both civil as well as military rule. Some years it had been having the civil rule, that is the political form of system was the democratic system over there, but many a times there had been military dictatorship also. Nepal was a constitutional monarchy with a danger of the king taking over the executive powers. So there was a constitution, there were set of rules and regulations, but the head of the government had been the monarch, and the monarch had some extra powers, extra constitutional powers, and that was a threat for the country that it may fall into the strict hands of the monarch and there could be threat to democracy. Bhutan is still a monarchy, but the king has initiated some multi-party system in the country, within the monarchical system itself. That means in the executive, there are representatives of the people from different parties, but still the head of the government is a monarch. When we talk about Maldives, Maldives was a sultanate empire. Till 1968, it had been a sultanate. And later on, it was transformed into a republic with presidential form of government. Later on, after 1968, they formed a republican form of government, and there was not a prime minister, there is a presidential form of government, just like it is there in USA. There is no post of prime minister. All the powers of the prime minister are now in the hands of the president. In 2005, Maldives introduced a multi-party system, and since then they are having a multi-party system of democracy in their country. Despite such a mixed record of democracy in these countries, they all share a common aspiration of democracy. Despite there being different forms of government from time to time, monarchical rule also, dictatorship of military also, but still when we talk about the people's aspirations, the surveys done in these countries shows that people prefer a democratic form of government. All people in the region, whether rich or poor, whether following whatever religion, speaking whatever language, they all prefer to have and to respect the democratic form of government. They all prefer the democracy over and above dictatorial rule or monarchical rule or any other form of government. Now students, let us study the political history of these countries one by one. Let us first study the history of politics of our neighboring country, that is Pakistan. The first military rule in Pakistan took place under General Yahya Khan. The reason for his rule was the popular dissatisfaction against General Ayub Khan. Ayub Khan was not much popular among the public, and that is why General Yahya Khan took the power. After this, a government was formed under the leadership of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto in 1971. It lasted till 1977. So between 1971 to 1977, there was Zulfikar Ali Bhutto's government, and that was an elected government. Later on, Bhutto government was removed by General Zia-ul-Haq. Zia-ul-Haq led a military rule, but he had to face pro-democratic movement in the country in 1982, and since then for a few years he was criticized by the public of the country because there was more demand of democratic form of government in the country. Again in 1988, an elected government was formed as a result of such movement. The democratic government was established under Benazir Bhutto. But the Benazir Bhutto government also had to face lot of competition from the Pakistan People's Party, that is a political party, and another political party, the Muslim League. Muslim League, the oldest political party. So these two political parties gave a tough competition to Benazir Bhutto, and that way she was not much popular. She was too much criticized in the country. Then in such a circumstances, again the army stepped in, and General Pervez Musharraf removed Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif also from power, and General Musharraf got himself elected as the president later on in the year 2001. There were several factors which led to the failure of Pakistan building a stable democracy. So after General Pervez Musharraf, again a democratic form of rule was set up in the country under Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif. At present, Imran Khan is the Prime Minister of Pakistan. Now let us study the relation between India and Pakistan, the historical developments and threats that the relation faced between the two countries. After independence, both India and Pakistan got involved in the issues related to Kashmir. It led to wars in the year 1947-48 and later on in 1965 also, which failed to settle the matter. The matter was not resolved till date also. But the countries face conflict over other strategic issues also, like the control of Siachen Glacier and over the acquisition of arms by both the countries, because both the countries are doing research and development work in the field of nuclear weapons, and that also creates tension between the two countries. Both the countries continue to be suspicious of each other over security issues also. Another issue of conflict among the two countries is over the issue of sharing of river water of the river Indus. So Indus river water dispute also continues for a long time. Later on, an Indus water treaty had been signed between the two countries, but still it remains a sensitive and strategic issue between the two countries. The two countries are not in agreement over the demarcation of certain areas in Kashmir region, Ladakh region, and in run of Kutch of Gujarat region also. So these are the matters which continue to trouble both the countries when it comes to peace and security of both the countries. Later on in our coming sessions, we'll study about other South Asian countries and their relation with India.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe for more.